So now I'm going to record another video lecture that is on the Bell-Kalman cycle. Here a dense air refrigeration cycle operates between the pressure of 4 bar and 16 bar. The air temperature after heat rejection to surrounding is 37 degree centigrade and air temperature at exit of the refrigeration is 7 degree centigrade. The isentropic efficiency of the turbine and compressor 0.85 and 0.8 respectively. Determine the compressor and turbine work per TR per ton and COP and power per TR. Take gamma is equal to 1.4 and CP is equal to 1.005 kilojoule per kg K. That is the standard one. Now we will draw the sketch on the PA pressure volume diagram and again on temperature entropy diagram. You can see the sketch 1 to 2, 2 to 3. 1 to 2 is the ideal one, 1 to 2 dash is the actual, 3 to 4 is the ideal one, 3 to 4 dash is actual. So this is on the PV diagram. On the TS diagram also the same figure has been shown. 1 to 2 compressor work, 1 to 2 dash actual, then 3 to 4 expansion work and 3 to 4 dash actual. So we have drawn the sketch on the pressure volume and temperature entropy diagram. Now we will move to the calculation. So we have to calculate all the temperatures, that is the temperature of the air at the end of the isentropic compression. At the end of the isentropic compression in the compressor and T2 dash actual temperature of the air leaving the compressor. Then T4 the temperature of the air at the end of the isentropic expansion and T4 dash is the actual temperature of the air leaving the turbine. So we know the relation very well. 1 to 2 process, we know that the isentropic process compression is taking place for 1 to 2 sketch. You can consult the sketch T2 upon T1, P2 upon P1, raised to power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. We can put the value, it is already given. The values which are already given, P1 is equal to P4 is equal to 4 bar, P2 is equal to P3 is equal to 16 bar, T3 is 37, change it into Kelvin, then T1 is equal to 7 degree, change into Kelvin, efficiency of the turbine 0.85, compressor 0.8, gamma 1.4, CP this, CP 1.005 kilojoule per kg. From PV and TS diagram, cycle shown on the figure, okay? We have already have explained the cycle on the PS and TS diagram. So, now T2 upon T1 will be given by P2 upon P1 raised to power gamma minus 1 upon gamma. And from here, we can calculate the value, the ratio of T2 upon T1, that is 1.486. Similarly, isentropic expansion process 3-4, 3 T3 upon T4, P3 upon P4, gamma minus 1 upon gamma, putting all those value which is already given, we get the value equal to 1.486. So we are getting the value 1.486 there also, 1.486 here also. So T4, from there we have calculated T2, from here we will calculate T4. T4 is given by that putting the value of T3, 208.6 K. Now we have to see the compressor efficiency, that is isentropic increase in temperature upon actual increase in temperature. In the figure we can see isentropic increase in temperature, that is 1 to 2 dash, actual increase in temperature 1 to 2 dash is the actual and isentropic 1 to 2. So putting all those value over here, we can get compressor efficiency is equal to isentropic increase in temperature divided by actual increase. That is given T2 minus T1 divided by T2 dash minus T1. From here, we can already compressor efficiency is given 0.8. From here, we can calculate T2 dash, which is unknown. We can calculate T2 dash from here. So T2 dash is coming 136 upon divided 0.8 plus 280. That is 450 Kelvin. Next, it is given that isentropic efficiency of the turbine. Isentropic efficiency of the turbine, that is actual increase in temperature divided by isentropic increase in temperature. Again, from here we can calculate T4 dash, T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 upon T4. From this sketch you can get it. So, value of T4 dash we can calculate from here, this equation, that is 223.8 Kelvin. Now, we know that the heat exchange from the refrigerator or refrigeration effect, that is Cp T1 minus T4 dash. Let us see the figure. Cp T1 minus T4 dash. See, this is the portion of the cooling portion, T1 minus T4 dash actual. So using that relation, Cp T1 minus T4 dash, Cp is the standard value. That this we will know that heat extracted from the refrigerating effect, it is refrigerating effect rather I should say, Cp into T1 minus T4 dash, Cp ki value malum hai, T1 T4 humne calculate karke nikala hai, 56.48 kilojoule per kg. Now that, and the mass of the air flowing per ton of refrigeration, MA, mass. To kya hota hai, mass into heat extracted, that will be equal to heat extracted per minute, or mass of the air, heat extracted per minute divided by heat extracted per kg, mind it. So already we know heat extracted per minute, that is given in the question, 200 standard value kilojoule per kg, and heat extracted per kg, that is 56.48, we have calculated over here, divide them, we get 3.73 kilojoule per minute. Now the compressor work is given by WC. WC compressor work is given by WC, that is the from here to here, see, from here to here compressor work, from here to here turbine work. So compressor work WC is, WC means compressor work, WC, MA into CP, T2 dash minus T1 dash, T2 dash the actual minus T1 dash. MA already we have calculated over here, so putting the value of MA over here, we get MA into CP, T2 dash minus T1 dash. Calculating all those things, we get 635.6. Next, the turbine work. The turbine work, that is, one side is compressor work and another is turbine work. WT is equal to MSCP T3 minus T4 dash. From here, I can calculate MA, we know, CP is standard, T3 minus T4 dash already we have calculated. So we get the value of turbine work, 322.3. Now we know that the net work will be compressor work minus turbine work, compressor work minus turbine work. Already we have calculated compressor work and turbine work is this 322.3. Subtract it, we get 313.3 kilojoule per minute. That is the net work. So you know that COP is given by heat extracted per minute divided by net work done. Heat extracted per minute, standard one, TR, 210 kilojoule per kg. We will divide that with the help of 313.3. We will divide both, we will get 0.67. That we are getting to get the COP, that is the heat extracted per minute divided by net work done. So we get the value of 0.67. Now power required is the net work already we have calculated, WC minus WT, that is compressor work minus turbine work. So it has come 313.3 kilojoule per minute, kg per minute. So putting that value, net work we are getting 313.3 kilojoule per kg, and power required per ton divided by 60, we get 522 kilowatt. In kilowatt we have to divide the work by 60, we get the power. So all the three values have been calculated over here. First one was asked, that is the turbine work, then COP, then power. Turbine work was already we know that MA CP T3 minus T4 dash turbine work, and compressor work was here already calculated previously, 635.6. so the total work has to be deducted, from there we will get the work, and from that CP we can find out COP, and then power required. That's all.